ladies and gentlemen. We welcome viewers live and exclusive to Europe's premier sports channel, Sky Sports and Ringside on the Road, from the River Mead Leisure Centre in Reading. We're Frank Warren for Sports Network Europe in association with Chris Sanagar, proudly presents Championship Boxing. And first of all, the WBO Intercontinental Super Middleweight Championship. And would you please first welcome to the ring the challenger for the title, Cornelius Carr.
Cornelius Carr represents a pretty stiff challenge to the prospect Dean Francis. Remember, he's fought Steve Collins for the WBO Super Middleweight Championship, and after 9 rounds of that fight, Carr was in with every chance of maybe going on to cause an upset victory, but he just lacked the devil in the closing stages to get the job done, and Collins won well in the end. But that was a pretty good performance. Just look, Cornelius Carr is wearing headphones there to kind of shut everything out. He looks pretty concentrated, and the word from the gym is he fancies his chances big time of beating Dean Francis here.
I'm sure he will. I'm sure he'll think this is a very good opportunity for him to shine. He's wearing the headphones as he did in the Steve Collins fight. I'm sure there's something in there to really psych him up on the tip. But he's a good fighter at times, as you said, and he just seems to lacked that little bit of devil. He hasn't been that active, you know, over the last few years. So you often wonder about, you know, how much he wants it in the sport, but his boxing ability has always been very good.
From Middlesbrough, Cornelius Carr, still only 27. The ambition still should be there for him, and if he wins this fight, he may well get another world title opportunity.
Ladies and gentlemen, would you please now welcome the current WBO Intercontinental Super Middleweight Champion, Dean Francis!
Clear all is on. Clear all.
Well, there's some massive support here for Dean Francis tonight. He's from Basingstoke, which is not a million miles from Reading. 23 years of age, highly touted as a big prospect at super middleweight. But he came unstuck when he was moved up in class and fought Zafuru Balugu, who's now world-rated, and he lacked stamina that night and he was well beaten. Now he's stepped up in class again after some impressive victories. Can he fulfill the potential this time? If he really is as good as they say, this is a fight he must win, Glenn.
Yes, it's really a make-or-break fight. If he's going to go forward, he needs a good win here. It's a difficult fight. Carr has been around, very experienced. But Francis he seems naturally to be a bigger man. You'd expect him, he's got the punching power. And it's a fight that he has to be really concentrated in. He has to really do it right in this fight. He can't afford to run out of stamina. You know, and he needs a good win here.
Have been one or two weight problems in the past with him. He's a bit of an ice cream freak and admits to being a bit of a free eater, Dean Francis. That's something he needs to get under control if he's going to stay effective at 12 stone. Tail of the tape, Francis the younger man by 4 years. Carr more experienced. Francis is the taller man with a slight reach advantage. They're both just inside the 12 stone limit. Has had more fights and has already had that world title opportunity and also won the British title against the pretty good James Cook. Rules, WBA rules here, mandatory 8 count, no standing 8, the 3 knockdown rule will be in effect. That doesn't very often happen in a British ring unless one of the world governing bodies is operable, as is the case in this fight.
Ladies and gentlemen, the officials appointed for this contest, the steward in charge is Mr. Bernard Buckley, the supervisor appointed by the WBO, Mr. John Morris, General Secretary of the British Boxing Board of Control. Judges at ringside, Mr. Tony Walker from London, Mr. Phil Cowshill from Manchester and Mr. Marcus McDonald, also from London. The timekeeper tonight, Mr. Nick White, and the referee in charge of the action this evening, Mr. Roy Francis from London. Introducing the boxers, and firstly in the red corner, wearing the black trunks, coming from Middlesbrough, he has had 29 professional contests, 27 wins, 15 by way of KO, with two losses. He weighed in at 11 stone, 13 and 1.5 pounds, and comes to the ring as the former British champion and world title contender. Will you please welcome Cornelius Carr? And his opponent across the ring in the blue corner, wearing the purple trunks, the colours of the Bristol Boys. And coming from Basingstoke, his professional record is 16 contests, 15 wins, 13 by way of KO with just one loss. He's also scaled 11 stone, 13 and a half pounds, and comes to the ring tonight as the current Intercontinental Super Middleweight Champion, making the first defence of his title this evening.
Three British judges scoring, and referee Roy Francis, no nonsense ref,
he is. When you go down, corner, you don't come out until I tell you, you got it? Okay, when I say back, stand back, you got it? Shake hands, have a good one.
Those two will have no doubt about who is in control of them. Cornelius Carr, significantly, looks very, very fired up for the job. There was just the question mark about his level of ambition in the sport, as Glenn was saying. Only one fight in 92, only one in 94, and he hasn't fought in the last 12 months. But he knows this is a big one for him. It's an even bigger fight, I would suggest, for Dean Francis in the purple trunks from Basingstoke, and with massive support in this crammed full Rivermead Leisure Centre. Francis has only lost one so far against 15 wins, 13 of which have come inside schedule. Good puncher with both hands, and particularly the left hook, Dean Francis. Usually, though, Carr is pretty durable.
Yes, usually he is. He was knocked out on one occasion. That was as a light middleweight against George Bocco. But for the most part, he takes a good shot, and he stood up to everything Steve Collins had. So, you know, he's got to be pretty durable.
The junior world title, the intercontinental version, on the line here at super middleweight, which is such a buzzing division, of course, in Britain. Some old hands and some young guns around, and one of the young guns is Francis, and one of the older hands is Carr. Good left jab that from Dean Francis, and again he snaps it out, and very good looking punches from him there, fast hands. Important from Carr's point of view, really, you would think, to get through the first four or five rounds.
Yes, that was good sharp work from Francis there. I was impressed with that. He settled down well, he's got the center of the ring, he's landing with a good long jab, and there's a couple of nice sharp punches went in there, which I think just got Carr's attention.
Again, sharp stuff from Dean Francis. And he wrestles Carr across the ring, looking very strong. And he's shouting and talking to him in there as well. An extremely hyped up atmosphere in here for this one.
Well, he's looking very fired up, Francis, and he's landing with that jab. That's why he's getting the success. And he's just, Carr's just a little bit in disarray.
I think he's feeling the weight of these shots from Francis, who does have a punch. That looked like a low left. Keep them up, says the referee to Cornelius Carr. Left hook has Carr reeling back against these ropes. There's just a suspicion with Cornelius Carr that naturally he's a middleweight who's coming up into the super middleweight division. And this Dean Francis is a big super middleweight. He even flirted with light heavy for a while. And it could be significant. Carr looks distressed.
Yes, and you can see the strength of Francis as he almost wrestles Carr over there. But he's landing with the sharp punches, and the jab's good. He's found his rhythm very well.
Got in with another big left hook as well. He's landed with a lot of meaty shots. That was a great opening round for Dean Francis.
What kind of society do you want to be part of? At Britannia, we share our success not with shareholders, but with those who deserve it most. This year, we're sharing £35 million with our members in our first loyalty bonus.
£35 million.
And we'll share out a bonus every year. If this is the kind of society you want, then join us. For an information pack, call 0800 44 33 22. Britannia, we are the sharing society.
Welcome back to the Rivermead Leisure Centre in Reading. Live pictures, very, very good fight here with Dean Francis, the young super middleweight prospect, really going well in the opening round against Corny Carr.
He really did. He started very sharp, and there was the best punch of the round, that good left hook. It certainly had Carr in a little bit of trouble there, and he was looking to hold, but a great start from Dean Francis.
Carr really going for it right at the start of round two. Dean Francis from Basingstoke in the purple trunks of the Chris Sanagar camp. Carr from Middlesbrough up in the northeast. Former British champion and world title contender, remember. Steve Collins couldn't stop him. Will Dean Francis do it?
Well, I think what's surprising Carr in this early part of the fight is how good the jab is of Dean Francis. Carr is a good boxer, but he's having trouble with the jab, and then such a good left hook.
The Francis fans are on their feet, and Carr is taking rather too many at this stage, but he does have some resilience and durability. Carr suffered his first defeat in this very arena against George Bocco back in 1989. Is Reading a jinx town for him? Again, big right hand from Francis.
Well, Francis couldn't have asked for a better start. He's landing with everything. The jab's good. His sharp punches, right and left hands, and the left hook has hurt Carr from time to time.
Francis's career rather went to sleep for a time after everybody had been raving about him after that defeat by Belugu, but he stormed back with a series of stoppage victories, and he wants another one here, and this would easily be the most significant of his career if he could win it. It's been an explosive start from him.
And Carr has to get his jab going, has to try and get himself back into this fight. He's looked unsteady several times. This is going to give Francis lots and lots of confidence.
Looks as if Carr's been a bit surprised by the power of Francis. There's another left hook, and again, Carr has to take that one. Right hand as well. Carr's looking for things on the counter, but really at the moment, it's just crumbs for him.
Yes, and he's got some damage around the nose, I think, Carr. He's took several very hard punches.
And a bit of damage too underneath the left eye for Cornelius Carr. Wonder if there is a cut just beginning to develop there. Can Francis keep this up? That's another question.
Yes, and there's also, to add to his problems, a cut to Carr's right earlobe. I think that's obviously the damage caused by the good left hook from Francis.
Cut underneath the left eye, and a cut by an ear as well. It's all Dean Francis so far. Well, these Reading fans are loving this. Of course, a lot of them have travelled from Basingstoke.
Well, a terrific round again for Dean Francis. Just look how he got them punches off. Look how many times he's just in that brief encounter, he landed with the left hook. Very good work for Dean Francis. He looks very sharp. He's very up for the fight.
He knows how important it is for him, because if he wins this in spectacular fashion, they'll definitely be talking about him as an opponent soon for Steve Collins or Robin Reid. There's no doubt about that. He's got the right connections too. Francis with a 51% success rate so far to Collins' 27%. Look how many more he's thrown and landed, and they've been big shots too. Round three. Dean Francis, the son of a former British title contender, Trevor Francis. His dad also fought Alan Minter and was an ABA welterweight champion. So boxing's in the blood in that family. Francis, remember, in purple. Cornelius Carr in the black and under heavy pressure early on. He's done well to stay on his feet, hasn't he?
He has done well. I mean, he's been out of the ring for almost a year, Colin. You think there's got to be a bit of ring rust there. Certainly it has not been a good start for him, and he hasn't really gotten into his rhythm and getting his good boxing going.
Carr has only been down three times in 29 fights in his career to date.
Again, clubbing left hooks, with Francis doubling it up there.
There was just that question mark against the stamina of Dean Francis when he lost to Zafiru Balugu, who's a distinctly useful fighter. Francis was not ready for that on that occasion, and I think had weight problems going into it as well.
Carr trying to push forward there, but walking onto a sharp left from Francis.
At this stage, Cornelius Carr's game plan really must be just to ride the storm and hope to come back later.
It's difficult for him when Francis is using such a good weapon as that left jab, which has been a very good, solid punch, and he's landed time and time again.
Early on here, Dean Francis has looked very good. To hear later on what another of our young hopefuls at this weight, Joe Calzaghe, makes of Dean Francis. Calzaghe did beat Francis in the amateurs, stopped him in a couple of rounds. Left hook not really landing flush from Francis that time.
Carr's very game, he's trying to push forward behind his own jab, but just falling short, and there, a much better jab from Francis.
I mean, that was a jolting looking shot from Francis. Not quite as spectacular and explosive in this round, but still dominant.
Isn't modern technology amazing? The internet?
Laser technology!
The world of virtual reality!
And now, energy efficiency!
The cleverest fellows have made products and services that save energy. Like bulbs, heating, insulation, fridges, double glazing. You put less in, but get more out. So remember,
energy efficiency equals more cash to you. At this party.
We're live in Reading tonight. Still to come, Ryan Rhodes' defense of the British Light Middleweight Championship. Live in the ring, a very good fight, and a significant one too. Dean Francis and Cornelius Carr.
And just showing there what a good weapon that left jab's been. He's really used that punch very well. There we see the tools. Francis, a good lead in the jabs there. He's really beating Carr to the punch with that.
Fourth round. Francis in purple. One defeat in 16 contests so far. Beaten people like Darren Griffiths and Hunter Clay, the old Nigerian veteran. Carr, who won his British Championship fight against James Cook, who was quite hot at that time. Never defended it and gave it up.
Yeah.
has Carr weathered the worst?
I think the good thing about the last run for Francis was, even though he didn't really pick it up, maybe just had a little sit back, he still, for me, won the round because of his good jabbing.
Maybe Dean Francis, just growing in experience too as a professional, will know that Carr, nearly all the time, does go the distance, and he will have to pace it a bit. Can't afford to punch himself out.
But I think that's a lesson that he will have had to have learned from his loss, to pace himself but still be busy, and that's what he's doing. He's still be busy behind the jab, but you know, he's got to pace himself throughout this fight.
Well, let's see what Carr has got to try and force his way back into the contest. He's always been a good technician, useful, methodical, but maybe just so far in his career, Carr lacking that something extra to make him a world-class fighter. Top world-class, I should say.
It'll also be interesting how it affects Francis when Carr takes his shots and he's still there. Will he start to get frustrated and start to, you know, just lose his game plan a little?
Breathing a little more heavily, Dean Francis, I've noticed, over the last round or two. Maybe that's just a little idiosyncrasy of his. Or maybe he is just beginning to tire. Time out, Roy Francis says. Low blow warning for Cornelius Carr. The next punch he threw was a bit south of the border too.
Yes, that was a low punch. Well, good punches from both men there. Carr with the right hand, Francis back with his left hook counter.
That's good work again from Francis. Fast hands.
Yeah, he looks very, very sharp in this fight. As good as I've seen him.
Isn't modern technology amazing? The internet?
Undetectable stealth aircraft? No!
The world of virtual reality!
And now,
energy efficiency! The cleverest fellows have made products and services that save energy!
Light bulbs?
Heating, insulation, fridges, double glazing! You put less in, but get more out! So remember,
energy efficiency equals more cash to you!
At this party.
Test cricket Saturday at 12 noon, Sky Sports 3, the second day of the second test in Port Elizabeth, South Africa against Australia. Live boxing here now, and it's becoming a real tear-up between Dean Francis and Cornelius Carr. The fifth is next. Thank you, Paul. And still to come, don't forget Ryan Rhodes trying to win that Lonsdale belt in record time, 90 days. Fifth round, Dean Francis, who been absolutely on fire in the early rounds here against the former world title contender Cornelius Carr from Middlesbrough. Francis just fighting a wee bit more in fits and starts over the last couple of rounds. Still in control, very much so.
Yes, you wonder whether he's starting to tire a little, or whether that's a conscious effort just to pace himself a little bit, you know, not be reckless. But I think Carr is very experienced, and Francis can't allow Carr to start clawing his way back in the fight. He's got to keep in control at all times.
Good combinations again from Francis, but here's Carr's response. Walk forward aggression from him for the first time in the fifth. Francis has never won beyond eight rounds. He's never been beyond 10. Carr knows this 12-round trip pretty well. Definitely breathing heavier, Dean Francis, as this goes on.
This Nisana is still doing more, which is not quite as sharp. Credit to Carr, he's trying to battle his way back in, he's trying to push forward and put Francis off balance. Francis just not as accurate with that jab as he was in the first few rounds.
He's just become a little bit more tentative, as if he's starting to think about it a little bit more. It's that awkward phase maybe for a fighter where he's thrown his best shots and the man is still there in front of him.
Some good lefts there from Francis.
Cut damage has been patched up pretty well by the Cornelius Carr corner. Howard Rainey, the trainer in there. Intriguing contest here, and much anticipated in the trade, I might say as well. Ian Dark and Glenn McCrory with you, live at ringside at the Rivermead Leisure Centre in Reading tonight, and Dean Francis against Cornelius Carr.
Francis showing good punches there, the long left, the long right, but he just dropped off the pace a little there. He allowed Cornelius Carr the chance to take over, I thought, in that round, but Carr didn't do it.
Carr doing more effective work to the body, though. That's interesting from our computer statisticians tonight. Sixth round. Francis purple, remember. Cornelius Carr black. The WBO Intercontinental Super Middleweight Championship, which is just a kind of junior version of a world title.
That's right. Oh, I've got it, Ian, with Francis in a big points lead. Carr's got to do something. He's got to try and change the course of this fight.
You do wonder what Carr has got other than outlasting Francis to get back into the contest with. What do you think?
Well, he's got to try and do something special. You see on the stats, he's trying to throw body punches. He probably watched the tapes and realized that what Balugu did to wear Francis down, and he's trying that, but he's not having as much success as Balugu did.
You know, that was a very, very different fight. Balugu has gone onwards and upwards in the world rankings since that, so that defeat doesn't look so bad now. It's a good left hook Carr got him with there. He's trying to take things to Francis a little more now. Not the same sharpness about Dean Francis. Was he just on a short fuse for the opening 2-3 rounds? We'll see.
That's right, Carr is pushing forward, but Francis still landing with decent counters on the retreat.
This is the night, I think, when we find out whether Dean Francis really does have it to go on to the next stage. And that's what makes this fight so very interesting. When he's in top gear and he's really flying, he looks so good, Dean Francis, but there is this little doubt about his stamina, his ability to last the course.
There's a good punch from Carr there with a left hook. He's getting a little bit more confidence, starting to put Francis under a little bit of pressure.
Are we just seeing the beginning of the turn of the tide here? I wonder. Oh, that's a great right hand on the counter. Carr walked onto that. Breathing more deeply still, Dean Francis. You do wonder. That's cars round, Harry.
Yes, Carl was doing more work. Francis at the very end got through with a good right hand, which just seemed to shake the legs of Carl for a little second, but Carl's really trying to claw his way back into the fight, putting the pressure on Francis. And if Francis has got any stamina worries, it looks as if Carr's going to try and see what they are.
Cornelius Carr, who once boxed two exhibitions in the Louisiana State Penitentiary when he was handled by Bo Williford, who he was with you for a while, wasn't he, Glenn? But he won both of those two, but they were real tear-ups. Had to knock the guys out in the second round to stop them.
That's right. I think he went there thinking it was just going to be an exhibition, and they really jumped on him. He had to end up knocking them both out.
G'ing him up in that corner. I still believe he can turn this around. It's the seventh round. Carr is battle-hardened. He's been there before. He was in a real tough one with Steve Collins. That kind of experience you can't buy. And so far, Francis, for all his talent, hasn't had that. And Carr is just beginning to feel maybe that he can turn this around.
Good left hook there from Francis and the right hand.
That's a good answer from the youngster. Stiff jab as well. Francis suddenly comes on strong again. Needed to reassert himself.
That was a good answer back from Francis. He's shown that sort of character. That's the sort of character he needs if he's going to step up a level.
Francis can come through this with a win against his name. You feel it might be such an important night for him. That's nice sharp punching again. The right hand is a real cracker. Didn't travel very far. Did trouble Carr.
He just looks to have regained a little bit of his sharpness in this round, Francis.
Just a bit of a second wind for the Basingstoke fighter, the most famous sporting son of Basingstoke, I guess, since John Arlott, the great cricket commentator, was with us.
Another good left hook as Carr walks forward from Francis.
And he's come back well in this round, Francis. Now, this is good stuff, and Carr is looking disorganized in defense here now. He's turned around again.
The referee was looking on closely there. Carr's head was rocking back. He looked hurt several times.
Can Dean Francis finish off the job? This is not what Cornelius Carr was expecting at this stage. He came out for this round full of bold intentions. He's been hit by some heavy shots. He's troubled now. Now the left goes in. Roy Francis is looking, and he stopped it. He stopped it in the seventh round, and Dean Francis has done what Steve Collins couldn't do. He stopped Cornelius Carr. It's the biggest win of his boxing life, and there may be bigger nights ahead on that evidence.
That was sensational. He really picked it up at a time when he looked like he was tiring. He pulled it out of the bag there. He put the pressure up again, and Carr just couldn't handle it. And the referee was wise to jump in there because Carr had took several very hard shots to the head. He was very brave, but this was certainly Dean Francis's night, and it was a very good finish.
Well, he showed there that he absorbed the lessons of the Balugu defeat. He'd gone back to the gym, he'd worked. He looked more comfortable at the weight tonight. He was so sharp, so fast, and so powerful, and he might be a test for anybody in this super middleweight division, this buzzing super middleweight division.
Yes, he really just, I think he'd been told in the corner to pick it up, and he answered that perfectly. You see the good left hooks. He was really putting good punches together here. You see the referee, Roy Francis, looking on, ready to jump in when them shots really rocked the head back of Carr. He was in very bad trouble, and that was a very well-timed stoppage there. Beautiful left hook, a lot of power, pulls it back with the right uppercut. and then puts on more pressure, the 1-2-3, and that's enough. No answer from Carr.
First time that Cornelius Carr has been stopped for 8 years. And Dean Francis did it. And both of those stoppage defeats have come in Reading. I don't think he'll be coming back here.
I don't think so. Steve Collins said he'd be very impressed if Dean Francis could do something to Cornelius Carr that he couldn't. Well, he did it, and he did it in good style.
He's really put himself in the shake-up with that one.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 2 minutes, 28 seconds of round seven, the referee, Roy Francis, stops the contest. Cornelius Carr in no position to continue. The winner and still super middleweight intercontinental champion, Dean Francis! Ladies and gentlemen, I'm sure you'd like to show your appreciation, please, for a very difficult and durable opponent in Dave Place, Cornelius Carr. And I'll now ask the supervisor for the WBO, Mr. John Morris, to present the championship belt to the super middleweight intercontinental champion, Dean Francis.
There's Steve Collins, there's Robin Reed, there's Wharton, there's Starry, there's Story, there's Joe Calzaghe, who's with us tonight. And now where does Dean Francis come in the pecking order with this performance? This was a night when he had to prove himself. There were big questions after his defeat in the most important fight to this date in his career. But Dean Francis has delivered a convincing victory. Let's hear how pleased he is about it. He's with Ian.
Well, that was an explosive, spectacular performance. We said it was the biggest night of your boxing life. What were your thoughts on that?
I thought I boxed excellent. Sweet. I'll bring anyone on now. I'm ready to box anyone.
You've done something there that Steve Collins couldn't do. You've stopped Cornelius Carr.
Because I'm a harder puncher, a sharper puncher, and a faster puncher. You understand? It takes SAT, that's what I call it. Speed, accuracy, and timing. And that's what I had tonight.
You looked as if you'd absorbed the lessons of that shock defeat you'd had against Zafiru Beluga. You've come on from that.
Experience. I learned a lot from that fight. I've been on the losing side, and I don't want to go back there. And there can be only one, and that's me.
You were, we were getting a bit worried about you after your explosive start. It looked as if you might be beginning to tire, and Carr was coming back into it. Then you found something more again.
Well, what it was, I said to everyone I was going to go out explosive in the first couple of rounds to hurt him, to make sure he knew I was there. And then in the later rounds, I thought, well, I got 12 rounds. He went 12 rounds with Steve Collins, so he must be able to take a punch. I mean, everyone gets hurt in the first half of the fight. So I thought, let me take it a couple more rounds.
What's next, do you think? Might you be fighting the winner of this British title fight between Starry and Story?
Definitely. Bring him on. Bring him on. I want anyone. I want him to box anyone.
And a quick word from Chris Sanagar. Must be very happy with that.
Definitely. I mean, we got a new kid on the block. I mean, it's nice to see someone go with a left jab, right hand, left hook. You know, back to textbook boxing. You know, it was a terrific performance. And, you know, just got to match him carefully, and I'm sure he's going to be a great world champion.
This super middleweight division is buzzing. I mean, we hate to rush young prospects like you, but which of the world champions would you be looking at in the next year, 18 months?
Well, anyone would want the easiest, so Robin Reed. He's a good boxer, but I'm better. Bring on Steve Collins. I'm better than all of them. So I'm not really bothered who comes.
You told me once before that you have a bit of problem with your weight because you love your food. You're a bit of an ice cream freak. You got that under control?
Definitely. Everyone loves food. Instead of two desserts, I have one. So I've got a wraps on that.
Whatever you were working tonight, I want some eating tonight. Well done.
Thank you very much.